vote to Haringey LTNs. That's why we're all here. My name's Alan Miller. I'm from the Together Declaration. We've come in solidarity today. We have a lot of signatories and members that are living and working in Haringey, as well as in boroughs across London and across the UK. During lockdowns, many of these LTNs were put in through stealth. We know they didn't listen to us when we did the so-called consultations, that they were very loaded questions. They treated us with contempt and they sidelined us. But we know in Ealing, they got rid of the LTNs. The people got together and got rid of them. We know that even in Oxford, where they're planning a 15-minute city, that Jericho has got rid of it. We know that in Greenwich and other places they've done it. We are in a position where we hold the power. Us, ordinary people, residents, businesses, and Haringey Council need to get the message. It's unacceptable to treat people with contempt, to sideline residents, to ignore us. Through our streets, no to Haringey LTNs.
I'm from South London, and I've deliberately come up to the North to show solidarity to all of you. Because, whatever they say, an LTN is an LTN, whether it's in South London, whether it's in North London, whether it's in Manchester, where it is anywhere else.
Yeah.
And what they are doing is totally unjust.
Yeah.
Because what LTNs do is they don't reduce the traffic, they relocate the traffic from the quieter streets to the busy streets. To the streets that are already busy, are already noisy, have already got pollution. That's what they do, and they don't worry about the people who are the losers as a result. As a result, on the main roads, we've got more congestion because of the LTNs, we've got more air pollution, we've got more noise, and we've got slower buses because the buses tend to be on the main roads. LTNs, wherever they are totally and utterly unfair. But as Alan was saying, I don't believe we will lose, because in borough after borough, people power has forced the local authorities to get rid of the LTNs. We can do the same in South London, we can do the same in North London, you can do it in Haringey, and I wish you all the best.
Quite a few of us here from Enfield. We protested, but they ignored us. Well done, Haringey, for being more militant than well-behaved people in Enfield. We're still fighting, so we've come here in solidarity with you. Good luck!
We do not have less and higher people. Everybody is equal, wherever they live, regardless of their age, their health conditions, their postcode. Everyone is equal, and this gathering represents everything that is amazing about London. I've grown up in London my entire life. I've been a proud North Londoner. I've been a visitor to the Middleton Road shops for my entire life, and I've been decimated by these policies. So solidarity to all those local people. This is everything about Britain and London that I love and that I'm proud of.
LTNs! Stop the LTNs! That's right! Come on! Woo!
People are being fined for driving in, you know, on roads that we should be driving on. And the council is making a lot of money out of it for no reason, that you find other ways of making money, if that is the case. And if anything, they need to be working with us to make the place a better place right now. I'm not happy with the LTNs, and they need to remove it today.
Stop this madness!
All I can say is this
restriction and the roads have turned our lives upside down. It's impossible to get one place to another, especially during busy times. It's hell. I don't understand how this can possibly improve the pollution, help with the weather and all that here. It's not something we want, and we just want our roads back because we are the ones who live here, and it should be up to us how we should have their roads.
No to Ltns, say no to Ltns.
My name is Roland, I'm from Bounds Green, and I'm here today to show some, I say support, really to raise awareness as much as anything, because there appears in action a plan to turn London into a series of cul-de-sacs, and it really has cut people off from their communities. My history on this goes back 2.5 years when during COVID something comes through the letterbox to say we're closing your streets, whereas before we had north, south, east, west access in and out of our community. We were only given one way in and out via the North Circular, and it really has cut us off from our communities. I will go so far as to say it has cost lives during a pandemic. We've had emergency services blocked on roads, not knowing they could go down them through filtered, as they call them, camera controlled entrances. My biggest concern is that the way this has been done, it's been imposed upon us. It is literally trying to instill behavioural change from the outside, and that's not what we vote for. We are a democracy, and we are meant to choose our leaders who stand on a mandate. This wasn't in their mandate when they stood, and yet they've pursued this path.
They don't care about quality of life or health of the people who elected them.
My name's Sue Ellen. I'm a local resident in Haringey. I wasn't aware these LTNs were being brought in until they were actually established. Only when they were established could I not go home. People think LTNs, low traffic neighbourhoods, the residents are allowed to drive within them. They're not. I can go up one road, enter one road, exit one road. I cannot even drive on the roads next door to me. So it's the way it was brought in that we disagree with. Car drivers, cyclists, walkers, we all get on. It was the way the council forced this upon us in a draconian manner.
We're here from Colchester because we completely don't support the government and their lies and charging us to basically exist.
I'm here because I've been a Haringey resident since 1999, and it's about time that the council and the decision-making powers listened to the residents. It's just decision-making willy-nilly without anyone really truly consulting. Our voices need to be heard, and you know, we are the taxpayers. We're the people who pay their wages. So they need to take into account how we feel, what we say, and not just sideline everybody.
This LTN should never have been brought in. This is a way of ethnic cleansing and controlling people that didn't need controlling. They brought in the CPZs, which were taking revenue off of people for parking permits. Now, this is a total abomination. 25 minutes to get from your local petrol station to your house. People living at one side of the borough need 3 permits. Now, one girl who lives the other side of Daniels Park has to have a permit to see her mother on Philip Lane every day. She used to go once a day, now she goes twice a week because she can't get there. Everything's being pushed onto the high roads. We've been killed in all but name and nobody's listening. The one question is why? This happened before when they enforced CPZs. They took all our money, imagine how much this is going to rake in. And what are they going to do with it? Where's the social housing? Where's the childcare? We've got so many much food banks opening up in Haringey now, it's an absolute disgrace. Where's all the OAP care? Where is the services for the kids? We've got knife crime, murders going through the roof, and they put in an LTN for what? The money should have been better spent.
Ha 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 ha!